Hello friends, you are welcome to my YouTube channel. I am Dr. Krishna Chaudhary, cosmetic surgeon practicing at Cosmetic Laser Surgery Center, Prasad Chambers, Karve Road, Pune, India. Friends, a crooked nose refers to a nose that does not follow a straight vertical line down to the center of your face. It literally divides the face. Just like faces, crooked noses come in all shapes and sizes and forms. Degree of crookedness may be different, subtle or more dramatic depending on the cause and change in the anatomy. While crooked noses are usually a cosmetic and functional concern, a proper skeletal support is necessary to provide long-term cosmetic and functional results. To give the nose an appearance of being straight, the existing architecture is realigned or various grafts are used to provide a symmetrical and straight appearance. Most often, both strategies are used to straighten and make the nose symmetric. Overall, autogenous cartilage is a material most commonly used to restructure nose. Provides material with which to strengthen, augment, camouflage, and reposition the deviated dorsum, septum. Sources of autogenous cartilage are the nasal septum, both auricular conchal cartilage, that is ear cartilage, and costal cartilage if patient is ready. In my practice, ultrasonic piezoelectric technology is routinely used to make finer, delicate changes in the bony framework and septum base to achieve cosmetically pleasing results and restore breathing to normal. This technology is based on very fine vibratory ablation of bone selectively and bleeding, bruising, swelling and post-operative pain is tolerable. Thanks friends. Friends, before you visit my clinic, I request you to study your own nose in mirror. Study your photographs from various angles and note down specific requirements. Visit my website to see innumerable before and after photographs to know what can be done. Because you will have fair idea by doing all these things, and by the time you reach my clinic, you know exactly what you want. It is of paramount importance for me to understand your requirements, so accordingly I can tailor rhinoplasty to suit your requirements and give you the best results. Friends, in this front view, you can appreciate the curvature of the dorsum. It has more shifted to right side. There is a width increase, fullness in the bony structure, and nostrils are wider. Here these markings, yellow markings, arrows, three arrows shows clearly the width of nose has increased in the mid-vault area. This will be the incision line to open up the nose for surgery. These small triangles, both sides, will be incised to reduce the width of nostril. This blue dotted line, both sides will be lateral osteotomies. The bone will be cut to reduce the width. and midline incision, that is the median osteotomy, to reduce the gap and avoid open book deformity after osteotomies. In lateral view, side view, you can see this is the hump, and the markings, yellow dotted markings, show the line where the osteotomy, where the bone will be cut. In this way, the hump will be rasped, not cut, but it will be filed with ultrasonic inserter specially made for this purpose. This will give it a very smooth appearance. This is a base view. You can see this much waist shape skin will be removed from both nostrils to reduce the width of nose. Surgery, all the surgical steps, but many times during surgery, because of anatomical variations and unusual situations, I have to modify the steps. The procedural steps, preoperatively, the consent is routinely taken where patients all questions are answered and his consent is taken for the specific steps of surgery. And if relative is present, his signature is also always taken. Photographs, front view, side views, base views, left side, right side, and if required some more views, are always taken for documentation and which can always be compared with after surgery photos, maybe after 3 months or 6 months. Then the marking is done for hump, marking is done for osteotomy, and marking is done for columellar incision, which will eventually open up the whole nose. Surface anesthesia, we routinely apply topical anesthesia, it's called as top lap, is applied to the points where injections will be given, so patient doesn't get pain during surgery while injecting the local anesthetics. Anesthesia proper, conscious sedation is there, patient is in sleep and he will not feel anything. Then the nerve blocks are given pertaining to the nose. Local anesthesia is infiltrated initially with a small bore needle and then larger syringe. And if required, it is time to time repeated in that particular area where the surgery is going on. Operation step is an external approach. This gives me wide access and direct view of the whole anatomy of the nose. And my both hands are free and I can use all instruments including ultrasonic inserters which requires more space. First, the deviated septoplasty is done to correct the deviation. The nasal passage is open. Splint technique is used on convex or concave side depending on the requirement. To straighten the septum, then hump is rasped with ultrasonic inserts. After that, the lateral osteotomies are done, medial osteotomy is done, and LR reduction is also done at toward the end. And incision is closed in layer, and plaster cast is given for 7 days. Patient is given 7 days course of antibiotic and painkillers that takes care of his pain and discomfort. You can see the results before and after photo front view. The hump is gone. The right deviation is not visible. LR reduction that has caused narrowing of nostril is quite obvious. Patient can breathe very comfortably now. There is no problem. Side views also show the removal of hump. Thanks.